Hi everyone, welcome back to the Drupal Academy. In this video, I will show you how to run a custom PHP version, that is PHP 8.3 on XAMPP by manually replacing the existing PHP 8.2 version. This method is useful if you want to quickly use PHP 8.3 without reinstalling the XAMPP. I will walk you through the exact step I follow. Just now I installed XAMPP, which has the 8.2.12 PHP version, because XAMPP don't have PHP 8.3 version. And to run the different applications like Drupal 11 and other applications, we need a PHP version as 8.3. This tutorial is for Windows users, and XAMPP uses the thread safe versions of PHP, so keep that in mind while downloading. So step 1 is, before making any changes, always take a backup. Backup your important files and databases to avoid any data loss. This is optional but highly recommended. Second step is, open the XAMPP control panel, stop the Apache and stop the MySQL. Third step is, rename your PHP folder. Go to your XAMPP installation directory. So I have installed XAMPP in my D drive. For you, the path may be different. So go to the XAMPP folder and find the PHP directory. Rename it as php_backup. So this is your PHP version with PHP 8.2. This keeps your old PHP version safe in case you need it later. Next step is, download the PHP 8.3 version. For that, go to this link, https://windows.php.net/download/php-8.3. Copy this and open. Download the PHP from this VS16 x64 thread safe. For that, click on zip and download it. The download is completed. Copy this folder or cut this folder and paste it here in our XAMPP directory. After that, extract it. Extract to this folder and now rename it to the PHP. Next step is, go to this PHP folder and create one more folder, that is Windows XAMPP PHP. For that, I will click on this new folder, Windows XAMPP PHP. Inside this PHP directory, again copy all content of PHP 8.3 and paste them in this directory, Windows XAMPP PHP. Now go back to our main PHP folder. Next step is, rename this php.ini development file to php.ini. So I will remove this hyphen development and click on this yes. So now our php.ini file is ready. This helps quickly enable required extensions like MySQL I, GD, PDO MySQL, PDO SQLite, and make sure your PHP configuration matches your previous XAMPP setup. For that, now I will compare this php.ini with my existing php.ini file, which we have in the existing php_backup folder. So find for the php.ini. Here is that file and open it again. Now we need to compare these two files to check what are the configuration changes. For that, you can use the online website or any compare tool. I prefer to use the devguru.com. This website compares the changes between two files. It has functionality to merge the changes. Also, this is the privacy first tool. So first I will copy my php.ini file from the old php 8.2 version. I'll paste here. Next I will copy this php 8.3 version php.ini file and paste here. Click on this find differences instantly button. So it redirects us to direct first change. So this is our old php file and this is new. So compare these changes. Mostly you need to merge the changes, those are related to the path. So I will move quickly. Also we need to check the extensions as well. So these changes are just space related, so we don't need those changes to merge. So memory limit, if you want to increase memory limit in your new PHP, so I will merge this change. Again this one. So post max size I want 40 MB in the new php.ini, so I will merge this one. So this is the one path related change, include path. So my XAMPP is installed at this path dxamp, so I need this path in my new php.ini. merge this. Again extension underscore directory path, I'll merge this as well. Upload temp directory path, upload max file size. So you can do changes as per your requirements, like this max file upload. Again go to the new changes one by one. So now we need to enable these extensions bz2. Merge this. Again extension equal to curl, file info extension, get text extension, and this mb string, axif mysqli, again pdo mysqli, pdo sqlite. You can merge this change as well. Scroll down. So this will take little bit time, but if you do these changes carefully, then no need to worry. Most changes are related to the space, so we can ignore those changes, but this path related, we need to add those changes in our new PHP 8.3. Scroll down, scroll down. So these are the commented, no need to merge these changes. Again this curl.ca info, merge this change, open SSL, this one as well. Now we have merged all changes, so I think these changes are also not required. So first I will copy this change file and replace it in this PHP 8.3 version. paste here, save. Now go to XAMPP control panel, restart the Apache. We will check if it works or not. So here we are getting the error, it is not working now. Check the logs, Apache logs. Open Apache logs. So first I will delete the existing logs. You can save this file. You can start it. Here we are getting the error like www.example server certificate does not include in ID which matches the server. So here you can see in the XAMPP PHP extras folder, it is not able to open that file, browse cap.ini. So go to this path, XAMPP PHP extras. PHP extras. I will open that old PHP version as well. Go to PHP backup extras. Here you can see there are these files are available. Copy these files and paste here. Again try to restart it. Now here you can see the Apache and the MySQL is working. I will refresh this page. Right now it is showing the 8.2.12. We will see if it is updated or not. So it is now updated our PHP version to the 8.3.28. Even if doing these changes and still your Apache is not working, in that case you can follow this step as well. In our latest PHP version, you can see these folders are not available, like CFB, compath info, data, docs. So copy these folders from old PHP backup, like as this, data, docs, this man folder, peer, script, test, and www, and you need to again copy these files as well. First is compath info web driver test example. Copy these files and folders, paste it here in your latest PHP version. So make sure it is not replacing any file. All these are the new files. Again, you can stop it and start it. And that's it. This is how you can upgrade your PHP 8.2 to the PHP 8.3 version manually in the XAMPP. This method is quick and helpful when you want to test the latest PHP features without reinstalling the XAMPP. If this video helped you, like the video, share it, and subscribe to Drupal Academy for more PHP and backend related tutorials. See you in the next one.